Country means culture, basically, to me.
I originate from Murray Island, or known as Mur, in the eastern part of the Torres Strait region.
My country's Palm Island. I was born there. It's very dear to my heart, very critical and central to the work that I'm doing.
I was employed at the Murray Island Primary Healthcare Centre, and during that time, I was employed for 7 years, but during that time I saw the diabetes epidemic sweep through the Torres Strait, and I saw how poorly managed diabetes can have an impact on a population.
You know, I grew up with the whole social, psychosocial climate on Palm Island, the political climate, seeing things that I believe need changing. It's really teething year. For me, I was bringing my life experiences in, as well as I had a really strong idea what I wanted to do.
I think writing your proposal was probably sort of the challenge at the start, because you sort of got to find out, okay, what methodology you're going to use and how you're going to implement it within this community. And so that was sort of a bit of a challenge, but the guidance of my supervisors sort of tailored it.
The advisory panel was a strong team of people who made the journey somewhat easier. Without them, I wouldn't be here.
The next steps were making sure that I was connected to country, because one of the crucial parts of my PhD was to have a connection with the Bulgarman storytellers. My thesis is very narrative, so it tells a story.
Things aren't easy in a PhD. The journey is an uncertain journey.
And I think the difficult part in there is if you have it also has an impact on your personal life.
It's a team thing. It's the friends. These are your friends, and your advisory panel is in a sense your family that gets you towards the end of your PhD.
Our interactions were around educating each other sometimes, but also taking direction from them as a supervisor. And I think that's really important, that for Indigenous scholars that are coming in, your supervisors might not know, you know, Indigenous knowledge. And this is your opportunity, you know, to teach as well. So don't be afraid of that.
Being away from your personal life to just focus on your doctorate, I think that's one of the biggest challenges that I had within my whole candidature.
The biggest challenge to me was the emotional uncertainties of what would happen at the end of your PhD. It is important to start planning 6 months prior to your intended conclusion of your PhD. Work that you will be doing at the end of your PhD.
The biggest challenge was telling myself that what I was doing was you know, valid. The knowledge that I brought, it wasn't second best to academia, that I had a different kind of knowledge that would enrich academia.
So my whole research was looking at improving diabetes care and management in the remote primary healthcare centres of the Torres Strait. And what mine contributed to was in trying to improve a workflow.
The whole research was about bringing a different perspective from a strength-based stance or platform to look at families that way, because we've had so many, you know, negative things said about Aboriginal families. I wanted to turn it around. For me, I had to keep my eye on the prize, which is finishing, and why I started the journey, because I wanted to bring about change in community.
I set out to gain so much knowledge around diabetes. Little did I know that there was you could gain a research degree or an honours degree that could lead into a doctorate and where I am today.
I wish I'd known at the start of the degree exactly, because I'm a very structured person, and I like the plans, and I like sticking to plans, but I wish I'd known how flexible things would turn out.